All right, so we've just come round to the driver's side of the engine bay of this beautiful 1938 limousine that Ziggy is the custodian of.
Yeah.
What's happening here, Ziggy?
Yeah. This, also this car have the original and correct Solex carburetor. That the number is 30FF Kai. The only carburetor is for that particular model. Nothing else fit. You can modify. There's another story. This car have like extra. They have like compressor and vacuum. The compressor, see these tiny things. If you want pump your air, you have adapter and you have like compressor. It's like small compressor.
Right.
On this section, this small pipe, you have not the adapter. You have vacuum, and you can use these things to repair your brakes, like vacuum the fluid from the brake system using that connection.
Right.
This is extra. Now this one is the original central lubrication. You can lubricate the car by pressing the pedal under the dashboard so often, and you lubricate the whole car, like the suspension. You can lubricate the transmission bearings and other stuff.
Oh,
it's original. It's original. Come with the car.
And where do you get the stickers from? From a 1938 car?
Well, stickers is not original. I made the stickers myself, you know.
You didn't tell me it was modified. Hold on a minute.
Yeah, well,
you've got to go into a different section for that.
See, because you see what happened. If you not put anything, some people think, oh, maybe this is oil and this is brake fluid. You see, you have
enough.
To know a bit. Yeah.
And this is how they made the air filters in those days?
This is air filter. What happened is two. It's not a filter in, and you have to put bit. Sometimes you have to put bit oil on the bottom of the filter to catch all the dust, things like that.
Right.
You know.
Are they paper filters?
No. Those metal filter, and with the tiny hole, like sort of wire and things, and you catch all the dust to the filters. You know that.
So are these engines easy to work on?
Yeah, basically that engine is not really, you know, have to be a genius to really restore. There is another here, this one in this carburetor, this is here special, like if you don't know, you don't know what is it. This is the like small jet, you call economy run. See, if you pull the things you push in, you're using less fuel. The call here, only on this carburetor, have the economy run. It's linkage, and they're going under the dashboard, on the top of the dashboard, and it's for the economy run.
Oh.
This is correct, this one. This,
I've got that on my E400.
Well, I don't know, modern car, but see, this is few things, even if you... The distributor, if you want to lubricate, this is grease. You turn a few times and you lubricate the shaft here.
So it's 1938 and we've got self-lubricating parts.
Yeah. Same as lubricate your water pump. You have two lubrication. So you have this, the main bearings you lubricate, and it's not a bearing. You lubricate them by turning. It's grease, special grease. You put it in and you lubricate, you know.
So in those days then, Ziggy, if you're just using the car normally in the 30s, late 30s, what would you do that, once a month or once a year?
Well, this is sort of like this, you can do maybe every 3 months to do that lubrication. But
right.
The central lubrication you can do every few days, morning before you start the car, you press the pedal and you have oil everywhere. All your central lubrication, because it's all connected to the... The only problem was after the war, they're not using... There is a bit mess, because if you have garage and you have started to lubricate your car, you have oil bit dripping there, because it's very thin oil to lubricate. But that how was built this car.
So how do you know what oil... They used in those days.
Yeah,
and can you get it today?
Yeah, you can maybe. You know, exactly what oil, but they're using mineral oil. They don't use any synthetic oil. It's all mineral oil. Yeah. And I have the specification from Germany. You can really translate, like, convert that oil, engine oil, or lubrication on transmission to the modern oil, like, because to synthetic oil. They give you the numbers. Yeah.
I see it's got an engine brace. Here.
No, this is the adjustment your bonnet. See, you can if you set your car, see, you can adjust the bonnet. The bonnet be not too long or not too short. You across adjust this one.
And yeah. Even in those days, it's chromed.
Yeah.
Beautifully finished.
Yeah, it's, well,
even the fittings.
The car was much better finished 20 years ago because now is the time. Maybe I have to re-chrome some parts. It's nothing forever, but 20 years I restored the car and it was, you know, good. Look, I'm not professional restorer. This is hobby for me. I enjoy it.
Of course, just
to do this
it?
One. And I have knowledge for 30 years restoring vintage car. And I have now I restore all other parts. I have more parts for another car. But I don't know if I will be do it. I have, like, you can show them that. See, now, also are doing now,
toolkit.
Toolkit, yes, leather toolkit, but then I have to find a bit more things. And I'm not sure, this is copy old one, but I'm not sure exactly which one is going this direction. Because there's two different types.
So you've made these?
I make this one. I'm using old leather. Like, this is really from the old one. Like, used leather, which may give you that sort of aging. I'm using
age look, yeah.
From my...
antique look.
Yeah, like from old furniture. Very old one. You've been used for 50 years. And I put Mercedes here, but with maybe not necessary.
So if anyone's got an old leather jacket in the car,
yeah, I collect really what happened, coach, and I just took the pillow and done here. And also then I restored in spare time the grill. It's spare grill.
Well, it's so good to have something to do in your spare time.
Grill,
isn't it, Zeke?
And I mean, also, Vince, I have to show you, I restore spare big fog light, headlights.
Crikey, can we get them any bigger, Ziggy? I don't like the small ones.
This is big one. And also, I restore Nea, which is very hard to find, trafficators.
Oh, I love those. But when you say restore, Ziggy, that headlamp that you've got there, so that was just a rusted out old thing?
The world broken, this was rubbish. No good for anything.
So where do you find the glass?
No, the glass you can buy, and I have the glass originally because I bought maybe 30 years ago from Bremen a lot of parts, like nearly container parts, and I have the original things. But the biggest problem is on restoring these headlights.
What vehicle is that for? Is that for this?
This is the type of Mercedes.
Right.
See, there's all name of the glass here. This is all glass.
It's a bit hard to see, but it does say Bosch.
Yeah, Bosch. And the biggest problem to restore the body, because the body was completely rusty with the holes. I have the picture.
So you would have to strip that down and then rub it back and zip and dip it?
No, you strip. What you have to do, you it's no chrome anyway. They was so rusty. It was I can strip the chrome using wire brush. That bad was. There's holes everywhere, similar to this. What do you expect for 80 years old car? This is the fog lights. How was when I bought it from England? This the fog lights. Condition is when we remove the chrome, there was nothing left.
Apart, yeah.
And that my unique technique, electroplating technique, because I'm not grinding anything, I fill all the holes by copper or nickel here and that. Later on, I make special tools, and this is buffet to the mirror.
Is that a dipping process?
No. This is not dipping. That thing. First, you have to clean this one, and that you copper plated with the low current, and you plated, and you built the body like copper. But really inside the fog lights is still is the original body.
Oh,
this one is, if you say, I can say this is original light because I restored the lights and inside is everything original.
Is the original
yeah.
body.
Yeah, I replace all the rivets here, like, you know, because you have to take all the rivets, replace the rivets and straighten up them. There was dents everywhere. See, similar to this, I'm doing one now, one dome lights for one of the Mercedes. I make the lens, the glass, the glass here, and that is was that bad. There was holes everywhere. This done by electroplating.
Right.
This is the secret is, electroplating.
Good.
But it's not easy to learn because it took me 20 years to figure out how to do it.
Yeah, well, you're quick.
And now, what happened is, people say, oh, you need, ask me where you have all machinery. I'm saying, you don't need machinery because you're only doing one part. See, the problem is if you doing restoring cars for people, you need equipment. You need more because you have to do a lot of parts. But I only need one part, one left, one right. And now, yeah, now I'm just replace the correctly fog light 9030s.
Yeah, you had the yellow lamps on.
Yeah,
before,
yellow
didn't
was
you?
Not very happy, but now I'm a bit much happy.
Well, the yellow ones are probably from the 60s,
I have to make the bracket and the even bracket. Shift a little bit the bumper bar because it's too close to the mudguard.
Well, come on, Zig, it's a 9038 car and it's still not finished.
No, finishing. See, this is like you have to restoring Mercedes, you have to enjoy it, what you're doing. This is not for money. You're doing hobby.
It's a labor of love.
Yeah, correct. You know, you can't say, you can't really do for people because you spent, you know, really counted time and thing. But the restoration, I'll show you something. There, nothing to do with car. This is 100% mask, like for the virus.
COVID mask.
Yeah, this is plated on plastic. And now if you have the mask, all the bacteria only stay few minutes. On glass, few hours. This one, you see, if you have any bacteria, they die in few minutes because copper oxidate.
Right.
And nothing live on copper.
Okay. Well, I'm going to put that on and I'm going to run.
Okay.
Thanks, Ziggy.
Thank you. See, enough?